श्रीमती रमानुजाय नमः। अखिल हेय प्रत्यलीक कल्याण गुणैक तानस्य पुरुषोत्तमस्य हरेः सत्य दिव्य संकल्प जनिते इमे विचित्रमये प्रपंचे श्वेतर समस्त जीव विलक्षण चैतन्य संपन्न सजीवानां आर्तिहरः देवपितृ ऋषीणां दोषकारकः संज्ञान प्रज्ञान विज्ञान सत्तया प्रकृति पुरुष परम पुरुष तत्वावगाहन प्रतीति विचिति प्रगति प्राप्त्यादि विषयेषु समर्थः नर एव सर्वोन्नत इति श्रूयते दृश्यते च एतादृशेषु नरेषु अपि अनादि जन्म द्वंद्व वासनया विभिन्नाः विभेदाः दरीदृश्यन्ते यथा मनुष्याणां देहवैलक्षण्यमस्ति तद्वत् देशवैलक्षण्यमपि परिगण्यते बुधैः यथा भूमौ धातुरसद्रव्यादीनां नानारूपाणाम् आधिक्यं नैयून्यम् अभावादिकं विभिन्नेषु प्रान्तेषु अवलोक्यन्ते तद्वत् मानसिक बौद्धिक आध्यात्मिक अनुकूलता अनुष्ठान अनुकूलता शक्तिः प्रख्याते अस्मिन् भरतमण्डले भारते देशे एव विलसति इति सर्वेषाम् एकघण्टा अभिप्रायः। अत एव नरस्य देहसम्बन्धः उत् तस्य नरस्य भारतन्नाम देशसम्बन्धात् सः उत्तरः तत्रापि देशाचारसंस्कृतीनां स्वरूपानुरूप अनुष्ठानसम्पत्तिः सिद्ध्यति चेत् सः एव उत्तमः इति श्लाघ्यः इति सर्वेषां महर्षीणां सदात्मनाम् अभिप्रायः। विकसिते समाजे प्रवहन्ति असङ्ख्येयाः गुणाः धर्माश्च यथा सत्य अहिंसा प्रीति क्षमा धैर्य वीर्य श्री धी भूति प्रभृतीनाम् आयतनं भवति तत्क्षेत्रम् तद्वत् सर्वे सभ्यता लक्षणानि सर्वाणि सभ्यता लक्षणानि यथा ज्येष्ठानां श्रेष्ठानां गौरवं स्त्रीणामपि पूजनं गौरवञ्च ज्ञानसम्पत्तिः धर्मचिन्ता धर्मविचारः एवं विधियुक्तराष्ट्रपरिपालनम् एवं परतत्वविवेकदेवताराधन इष्टिप्रभृत्यादयः सर्वे अस्माकं राष्ट्रे एव विलसन्ति इति अस्माभिः अनुभूयते एव। अत एव सर्वेषां धर्माणाम् आश्रयः तपोभूमिः ज्ञानभूमिः क्रियाभूमिः कर्मभूमिः इति अस्माकं स्थानमेव संस्तूयते। अत एव शास्त्रेषु भाषा एव भाषमानानां जनानां कुलवंशपरम्परागत संस्थिति स्थिति परिस्थिति उन्नति प्रकृतिविषयिक प्रदर्शक आदर्शः तेषां मूल्यतत्त्वनिष्कर्षनिकष इति अभिप्रियते विद्वद्भिः। अत एव तासु भाषासु भाषाविषये तु स्वरूपवैशिष्ट्यं विद्यते विषयवैशिष्ट्यं विद्यते भाषायाः स्वरूपं तु माधुर्यं लालित्यं सारल्यं गाम्भीर्यं स्वातन्त्र्यम् इत्यादयः। भाषासु विद्यमानानां ग्रन्थानां प्रतिपादनविषयाणां गौरवविषयेपि अस्माकं संस्कृतभाषायाः वैशिष्ट्यं जगत्प्रसिद्धमेव विद्यते इति एतैः कथितम्। अत एव सर्वोन्नतभाषा जगति संस्कृतभाषा एव इति निर्मत्सराणां सतां मतं विद्यते। अत्र विद्यमानानां संस्कृतविषये अनभिज्ञानां सर्वेषां जनानां सुखतर सरल सुगम अवगमनाय आङ्ग्लभाषायामपि मया किञ्चित् उच्यते समाप्यते च। उच्यते हि प्लवङ्गमानां जन्म श्रीरामावतारस्य अनन्तरं ये तत्र प्लवङ्गमजन्तवः सामान्यतः परिहासास्पदा आसन् रामावतारस्य अनन्तरं ते सर्वे श्लाघनीयाः हनुमत्तत्वेन पूजनीयाः अभवन् तद्वत् वयमपि संस्कृतस्य माहात्म्यम् उक्त्वा आङ्ग्लभाषां वैदिकयामः पवित्रीकुर्मः। It has been well explained by the previous speakers about the greatness of the Sanskrit. Each and every person pertaining to a culture, a civilization, or pertaining to a way of life or code of life, he has two duties. One is to get all the benefits from the attachment, to get fame, to get name, to earn reputation, to get honor, and to be well established by wealth and prosperity by the tradition to which he is attached. that everybody is doing very perfectly. Each and everybody attached to a language and religion or a culture and tradition, they are earning name, fame, reputation and establishment from that. But in turn to that, his own contribution is of two types. One is samrakshana, second is poshana. When that particular dharma or the system of operation where he is attached to, if it is found out to be declined, then he has to support it with all of his might. That is poshana. Whenever there is an accusation, whenever there is a protest, whenever there is even a trace of blemish that is trying to be accusated on it, a person should try his level best to sacrifice anything for the reinstallation of the glory of his tradition. So that is paritrana and poshana. These things are the two eyes by which we can show the magnitude of our gratitude towards our culture. This Sanskrit is also having like a blemishes, which are known as adhyaropas, which are on that. And we have to understand that, number one, it is Brahmanyavada. Everybody says that it is belong only to the Brahmins. So the other sects of the people are totally against it. And it is having different sampradayas. The Kavya tradition is different. The Shastra tradition is different. Kala tradition is different. Bhasha tradition is different. The Amna tradition is different. There are limited types of admissions and limited types of demarcations in various systems. I think that it requires a very great seminar separately to be exclusively organized for vichara of all of these things. But what I want to say is, it requires lot of felicitations like austerity, penance, celibacy and various other principles which bring them the Brahminhood. So Brahminhood is brought 1/4 by the birth, 2nd 1/4 by the samskaras or rituals, 3rd 1/4 by the practices, 4th 1/4 by the transformation of your person's characteristic splendor. So Brahmanya is all encompassing, number one. Number two, somebody said that it is Mrita Bhasha. Even we can take it in the form of Abhyugamyavada. What is Abhyugamyavada? Even if you accept that it is Mrita Bhasha, there is no problem, because it is not that we can say that all people who have left the world, they are all bad incels, all those who are living, they are all superior in status. Number one. And number two, due to Kalikolahala Kallola Kalka, what we call the mysterious, the rampance of the period of the present era, lot of the things which are very much useful, which are very much provocative to the society, we have lost lot of things. Lot of great things we have lost in the era of time, in the wash of the tide of the time. Likewise, lot of unwanted things are still existing. That's what the Shastra say, that Anarhana Vishyanam Bahulyam Pracharaha Vyaptischa. Arhanam Vishyanam Kshayaha Bhangaha Apamana Tiraskaranadaya. So even worthy things are neglected and they are diminishing, and unworthy things are ruling and they are all pervading. So something which exists and which is permeable, that need not be considered to be great. Only for the reason that it is not existing or it is extinct, it need not be considered to be something unworthy. So what we want now is, if something is great, it is our duty, just as if we lose our health, we try our level best to bring it back. If we lose our wealth, we try hard to earn it back. Likewise, like dhanarjana and what we are getting into swastya by means of regaining our health, likewise we have to regain the health of our land is Sanskrit, the wealth of our land is Sanskrit, the spiritual pulse of our land is Sanskrit, likewise the treasury of knowledge, wealth is Sanskrit. So we should try our level best to bring it back. And this is known as Mrutavada. Then they are also doing a lot of other explanation, like whether it is Deva Vishayika Bhasha or Devaihi Bhashita Bhasha, innumerable such conferences and discussions and debates and dialectical studies and explorations are going on. Like that, they are also saying that it is a Prakriti Virodha or Prakriti Virodhaka. Now it is the nature of the world that it is dealing with various other evolutions in the form of, it is known as Sankana Kyuka. It is information technology, biotechnology, nanotechnology, cosmic technology. It is space exploration era. It is the era of space colonization. It is the era where we are trying to bring elixirs and avoid death and produce longer longevities. So at this era of hyper development and hyper involvement, getting into Sanskrit is a reciprocation or retrogression. It is known as Pragati Virodha. Somebody says like that. And somebody claimed that Sanskrit is the warehouse of all superstitions, as it brings everything into mantra, devata, upasana, siddhi, anushtana. All of these things are aprakrita and adrita. That which is impalpable and unintelligible. So it is the duty of each and every Sanskrit person to say that it is not a Brahmanya Bhasha, it is not a Mrita Bhasha, it is indeed veritably a Deva Bhasha, it is Prakriti Sadhaka, not a Nirodhaka, and it is very much essential to eradicate superstition, not to implant superstition inside. It is the duty of the learned persons who are multilingual, multidimensional, multiversified to implant these ideologies in the society. Now coming to the point of Prayojana, Prayojanam Anundishya Namantopi Pravartate. There must be a Prayojana, number one. One is Aihika Prayojana. Unless we have, there are some group of people in Sanskrit who are just research scholars working in American universities, vice chancellors, pro chancellors, and some heads of the department, they are well paid. And rest to those people who are well established, for the common person, what is the use of Sanskrit in Aihika? A normal materialistic view, what we can get? Can we get a Patavi? Can we get Aishwarya? Can we get Khyati? So for reputation, for establishment, financial settlement, they used to compare always with IT professionals, electronic engineering, their doctors and the various other professionals that are there in the society. A common person, a common mind used to always compare themselves with those people. So for that comparison, Sanskrit is still appearing to be insufficient, inadequate, or redirected to some other part of mystic darkness. So we have to make clearly understand that there are lots of opportunities. A real Sanskrit person should understand opportunities, make others to understand opportunities, create new opportunities, direct those people for new projects, emerging projects. I believe that Sanskrit has more projects than BPOs, KPOs and WPOs. But it should be properly entrusted to people by means of a reasonable direction. So the second thing is Amushpika. What is Amushpika? Transcendental. Getting knowledge, getting emancipation, getting self-realization. Nobody is interested in that. Even the great Brahmins, that's what I told. Most of the Prohit children, they are into business. And most of the Vaidikas, they are having the children who are nowhere distinguishable from Vaideshikas. So it has the tradition, even Amushpika tradition has been lost at all. Number third thing, Yoga, Ayurveda and various other essential sciences are there. That is a very big problem. It is known as Anuvada Vikara. In order to understand three things, one, understand the value of language, number two, understand the value and stuff of the contents of the treatise, number three, by which it can instigate and stimulate a small spark by which the person can go into research of Sanskrit and Shastra, Anuvada has been made. Translation facilitates only, understanding the glory of the language and understanding the glory of the discipline. But the same translation, now if I ask somebody to study about Bhagavad Gita and Sanskrit, they say that it is available in our regular translation. Why to go for the risky process of learning Sanskrit? So translation has been made to facilitate more apprehension in Sanskrit, to understand the originality of the language, to understand the madhuri of the language. It has been given to people. But it has been misdirected to the society that it has been the major reason for avoidance of reading Yoga, Ayurveda, Bhagavad Gita, everything available in translations. So it is avoided. This is known as Anuvada Nyaya. So this Anuvada totally differentiates everything. And the final thing what I want to say is, apart from this, there is Vaijnanika Parampara and there is Naitika Parampara. In Naitika ethics also there are three accusations. One, ethics need not be in Sanskrit, like honesty, purity, loving everybody. It is available in all religions. All ethical principles are available in all religions, number one. Ethics need not be a part or component of religion. It is a part of normal education itself. Education and ethics are normally coupled together. So if you want people to go for Yoga Ayurveda, they say about translation. If you want to go to the people for Naitika Shikshana, they are pointing out these things, like Naitika Shikshana is available in all religions. It is available even in educational texts like Aesop fables and other stories. Number three, even without being governed or intuited to the people, still by a normal, mature, civilized person, they can understand ethics without the use of Sanskrit. So these are the accusations. So ethics also has rejected Sanskrit. And in Vijnana, there are four main accusations. Number one is Nirupada. In most of the things like the Vaimanika Shastra and various other things, most of the things are not available. They are having a different hospitality, paribhashika prakara, by which we cannot understand what they are. It is very difficult also to prove those things. That is a problem. And second thing is arhata. In the normal education, it does not implant any arhata. Whereas in traditional wisdom or our vijnana, it gives lot of availabilities for the person to practice. Acharya pratipatti, devata vishwasaha, krama, brahmacharya, diksha, achara, niyama, anusthana. Innumerable bindings are there, without which a person cannot get that benefit at all. And the pratyogita is also there. For example, if you take our astronomy, no doubt we have dealt with gravity, the sun's motion, orbit, axis, light year and travel of light, everything we have mentioned. But still, whatever, there is a growth in modern scientific industry, that is Vartamana, Vriddhi, Pravriddhi. So it is growing and ever growing, whether it is correct or not, experiments are done, verifications are done. So the empirical dynasty or the lineage is growing, whereas Aryabhatta, Bhaskaracharya, that has a stagnation. And nobody is there in the contemplative parampara, that is Upasana parampara, to continue it in part with the homogeneity of the status of Bhaskaracharya, Aryabhatta. We are now just scholars. So sages, they were existing, then the seers, they came, then came the saints, then came the scholars. Now we are having just students and teachers. So that parampara has been lost at all. So what we want to say is, even in Vaijnana, we are not in complementary to all of these things. So we have to understand our loopholes and we have to fill it with property. And there are two paramparas which I want to say, somebody may be against it. It is known as Parivartana Dvikam. If you follow Vesha and Bhusha, you will enter into Bhasha. If you follow your Bhasha, you will enter into Vesha and Bhusha. It will make a person to fit into everything. That is what I feel and Shastras have said. If you follow a language without having a strong base of your culture, I am saying, there are also a lot of Mithyacharas in the traditional dress and Satyacharas in the different dress. That is Apavada, exception. But generally what I want to say is, the dress code leads you to language. Language leads to a culture. Culture leads to habits. Habit leads to mannerisms. Mannerisms lead to behaviorism. Behavior leads to character. Characteristics leads to cultural collapse. So, Veshabhusha, at least in our tradition, at least in pujas and everything, we have to practice. Because our dress code, our language, our culture, our morality, our deity, and the great glorious land of Bharat, everything are the components of the same tattva. We cannot have any separability or we cannot have any heterogeneity inside that. That is also very much essential. And coming to the real conclusive session of this lecture, I want to say that why is the declination? What is the reason for the deterioration of the system? Somebody asked me. I told that there were four schools. One is the Bhasha school, Kala school, Shastra school and Vidya school. At the time of inception of the Shruti Parampara, everybody they were doing the Upanishad Vidyas. Like Dharakasa Vidya, then Bhumagni Vidya, Panchagni Vidya, Vaishwanara Vidya. They were doing that vidyas with penance and they were acquiring great immense potency. And number two, it came into Shastras where they were just quarreling about which came first, Bijangodnyaya, then this Anta came first or Hen came first, all of these things like that of dry philosophy and endless infinite, anavastha we used to call, endless, mutually unending and deplorable status of a dialectical system they have taken, forgetting their upasanas. Third came the kalas, in which the people have been made so much soft, very much engaged in the process of seeing dance, drama, architecture, painting, everything, etc. At the time of this generation, the foreigners invaded, they colonized and we have been trampled into pieces. So I want to say that Bhasha is just an entrance, that's what I told. Samskritanam Bhasha, Samskritam. So we are Samskritas, we are refined by means of antarika samskaras like characters and bhashya samskaras like Garbhadana, Upanayana, etc. So we are Samskritas and our culture is Sanskriti and the cultural part component in the linguistic shadow is known as Samskrita. So Samskrita is only an entry. Through Samskrita you have entered into Shastras. Through Shastras you have entered into Sampradaya. Through Sampradaya you have entered into Acharya. Through Acharya you have entered into Sharanagati. Through Sharanagati you must get Aihika and Amushpika benefit in the form of eternal living here and there with all reputation. That is the purpose. So now even the Westerners they are going to come here. He has quoted a lot of such examples. Number one is yoga. Because they have learned everything. Technology is for happiness, harmony and health of the society. They have brought the technology but they could not bring happiness. Because they don't know the culture, that's what I told. It is psychotechnology. It is the technology of consciousness which is not there in the land. For which the only cradle, caught and thrown is our land. So they did not learn about these things. So when the technology reaches its worsened type, whenever it is raising its ugly head, at the time there needs a solution which cannot be given by the technical, mechanical Western world. Here is the world where we have learned psychology, epistemology, metaphysics, cosmology, eschatology and various other glorious traditions of science. They have to come here only, number one. Number two, human mind is capable of transforming into three stages. He will become either a krura or a murka or ummatta. Whenever he is not balanced with his mind and intellect, he will turn either into krura or murka or ummatta. For that only innumerable kalas are there, painting, music, dance, divine association, everything is meant for making a person to be free from krura, murka and ummatta stages. But whenever you see Western music, Western staging, dance, everything, etc., even a Niramaya, a pure person will become krura, murka, ummatta. That is the stage of West and that is the stage of East. So this is the greatness of India which we are going to talk. Now, we have to take the leadership. We have to take the global leadership in three things. One, in Kala, because we have to treat the contaminated minds of the society. The major threats of the society is conflicts, internal civil wars, terrorism, mass weapons of destruction. Everything is due to a contaminated and corrupt mind which wants to dominate and destroy the society. So that can be corrected only by the power of mind control which is there in, only in our shastras, number one. And number two, even in Vijnana, I have made a project to train scientists. It is known as Breya, breeding of young scientists. Scientists have four problems. One is Dura Drishti, Aghata Drishti, Sukshma Drishti, Samagra Drishti. They invent lot of things and after 1 or 2 years they say that it is pernicious, it is harmful, leave that. So because they are not having the Dura Drishti, what will happen after a few decades? Aghata Drishti, deeper vision. drishti, minute observation, observation of the nuances of the inner complexity. Then samagra drishti, composite view, they have developed IT industry, due to that only recession came, because they have not considered the holistic society. So, only if a person practices, not Sanskrit, whatever you say Sanskrit, it understands, or it is to be understood by the people that it is a culture of Sanskrit, way of living of Sanskrit, it is not mere Sanskrit. There was a Pandit. The Pandit was a very good orator. He had become dumb, so his Panditya is arrested. Number two, he has become paralyzed, so his mobility is arrested. Then he has got into coma, except his respiration, everything else is arrested. Likewise, the language which dwells only in speech, it is living only in respiration like a coma patient. But it is better than death, so we are maintaining it. A dead person is prevented from death, a person who is about to collapse is prevented from death by speech. Likewise, it is just an oxygen cylinder supported to Sanskrit by which we are trying to develop the speech. But gradually, home to home, ear to ear, mouth to mouth, place to place, it should spread into real survival of a fullest being by means of practicing the dharmas of Sanskrit, by means of living the way of Sanskrit, by which we have to show the real pathway to the society, by which we can bring, if a person is really cultivated with the process of Nitidhyasana and Upasana, certainly he will have the automatic cognitive drill feeling by which whenever he does an invention, that is the defect between both the people. Westerners, they are having good cognitive drill and good scientific exercises without the understanding of ontology, the fundamentals, Mula Tattva Vichara Shastra. We are having all Vichara Shastras and we are having also the Vichara of whether implementing the Vichara Shastras or not. So we are not united with them. So a meddling or a hybridization of Mula Tattva Vichara with a scientific temper, such person can create Samagra Drishti, Dura Drishti, Agar Drishti and Sukshma Drishti by which they can bring real, salubrious, all-round happiness to the society by his intervention. So, scientific guidance is possible by India to the society. Number two, mind guidance and intellectual enrootment can be given only by Sanskrit. Third, you know that Ayurveda, it is totally practiced by most of the people. Most of the people, they die only by medicines, and Vaidyarajas are once again proved to be the big brothers of Yamarajas, that is Yamaraja Sahodra. So in medicine, in yoga, in scientific heritage, once again we are going to take leadership. And I believe that it needs a workshop, an internal workshop between the like-minded people by means of intensive drilling, training and coaching. And I think the conferences are suitable platforms to involve people for that message. We can get like-minded people united. These stages are utilized for interaction and mutual acquaintance of like-minded people. We can gather this message. We have to create, whether government can do or not, I don't know, but people like Chamukrishna Shastri and lot of other industries in the society, and even after retirement, more people are becoming mukta. Now everybody is baddha. After retirement, they will be very much liberal, and with financial aid and proper guidance, there must be a technical training institute, not in Sanskrit language, but in Sanskrit culture and power of Sanskrit. You see, you should have a power. If you don't have a power, if you have just a belief and saying, everybody will trample on you. Even a spark of fire, if ignited and made combustible, that can eradicate all of your enemies and instill you great prowess. I want Sanskrit to create power in the society, and Prachara is just a beginning for that. And I wish that that institute should be started soon. And I also pray that I should be a part of that in financial sponsorship. And continued patronage I have to render for all of these things to bring the real glory of Sanskrit apart from mere language. Narayan, Narayan, Narayan.